Hello everyone, welcome to Carnivorous Plants Hub. Today I'm going to be bringing you an update on my Sarracena purpurea, or more commonly referred to as the purple pitcher plant. I'm going to be showing you how this plant's doing, also bringing you some general care tips, so if you have your own, maybe there's some information that I can bring to you that'll help you grow these. Real quick before we get into that though, I want to thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you so much. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, like my video. I'm trying so hard to start my own carnivorous plant nursery someday. Also in the process of working on bringing you my own carnivorous plant soil mix, which would work for this plant. But I just wanted to thank you again for being here. Subscribe to my channel, like my video, all that stuff is super incredibly helpful to me. But before we get into this plant, I did want to kind of show you real quick what it looked like a little while ago. So that update there was actually from back in May, May 2nd, it was about 6 months ago. Today's November 2nd, so that's about a 6 month ago. You can see that there was a lot fewer of them. They were a little more red. They'd been under some grow lights. They've actually been just growing completely naturally since then. So there's a few less that are red and a little more that are green, but I think that's kind of the best way to do it. Let's go ahead and take a little bit of a closer look here so you can see these beautiful pitcher plants. So you can see as they come up, I have a brand new one right here coming up, so you can kind of see the color of it as it's coming up right there. They are kind of a reddish, greenish color coming up, and then as they get a little bit bigger, they turn into this really bright, beautiful fluorescent green one. This is one that just came up, and you see there's another one back here, but they turn this really beautiful green color, which is really, really cool. That's probably my favorite color that they get, is that kind of fluorescent green. And then as they get a little bit older, this one here has been popped up for a little bit. You can see they start to get those veins on them, and they start to turn a little more of a red color. And they stay that color for a while, and as they get into the latter part of their life, they start to turn this really beautiful bright red color, which is also really equally beautiful as the red, or as the bright green. It's a really, really bright red color. But they're just a really, really beautiful plant. And what I found is that being in the Northwest where it's kind of cold, they actually do really well here. They're a super, super hardy plant. They're really not all that difficult to grow. You can actually just kind of put them outside and make sure that they have water. And for the most part, they do really well. They actually kind of require some of the same care as Venus flytraps do, if you're familiar with Venus flytraps. But the difference is that they're just a little more hardy and they need just a little more special attention. You can actually just leave the tray full of water. I have kind of a small tray on this one, so I have to water them probably a little more frequently than I need to. But if I got a little bit bigger tray, I probably wouldn't have to water them as often because they actually really like their feet to be wet. Make sure that you're only using distilled water. They will, same as most carnivorous plants, the roots will get burned if there's any minerals or any nutrients in the water. So make sure that you're only using a really a pure or distilled water. Also make sure that your potting mix is a peat moss and perlite mix. This is actually peat moss, perlite, and silica sand. Same thing with the soil. You don't want any nutrients. You don't want any Miracle-Gro. You don't want any potting soil. You don't want any fertilizer. All that stuff is really bad for these and will eventually kill them. So really important that your soil is also nutrient and mineral free. That's actually something I'm working on, is making a soil mix that will work for these, so keep an eye out for that. Hopefully I'll have that soon. Check the description, it may be out as you're watching this video, but not quite out yet as I'm videoing it, so keep your eyes out for that. They do like to be outside in the full sun. Right now I'm getting into November, so we're getting close to dormancy time, but during the summer and the spring, you can leave these completely outside in a place where they're going to get as much sun as possible. They absolutely love the sun, so make sure they're getting a lot of light, a lot of sun. It's really, really good for them. Come winter time, they actually should be left outside in most places because they do need a cold winter dormancy. So I'm probably gonna try to keep these anywhere between 25 and 40 to 50 degrees. I won't let them get any warmer than that. And I'll probably leave these outside all winter, either that or I'll leave them in a room that's unheated, like in my garage, so that they can stay cold all winter. They need that dormancy period to be able to survive and continue living for long periods of time. Without that dormancy period, they will actually die. So it's really important that you give them that cold dormancy period. Other than that, I think that's really all you need to know about growing them. If you have any questions, any care questions that you might have, go ahead and throw it in into the comment section, and I'd be more than happy to try to answer any questions you might have in regards to the care for this plant. But let's see if we can see. I'm gonna get my phone out here for some extra light. I want to see if we can see down into these pictures here. See, these are really good at catching bugs. The thing is though, is they're at kind of a weird angle, so sometimes it's hard to see the insects. So I'm gonna try to find one here that we can see down into. So there's one there. I know that's probably not super great. I wish I could get the light down in there and the camera. That's pretty good right there. You can see that there are several flies down there that this has caught. So it's actually a really, really decent carnivorous plant for catching flies. It does a pretty good job. You can see it's kind of a fly graveyard down in there. And I wish I could get a better angle on all these for you, because really all of these are kind of the same way. The purple ones are really hard to see. And most of the older ones that have bugs in them right now are purple. So unfortunately, I can't see inside all of them, but you can see this one here is a pretty good example of kind of what most of these look like in the bottom. And it's just kind of that bug graveyard down there. I've seen yellow jackets go down inside of these. I've seen flies. I've even seen like spiders get caught down there. Now you can kind of see all those down facing hairs. What happens is that those hairs point straight down. And when the insect tries to crawl out of that pitcher, they hit those hairs and they just fall right in. Either that or they're trying to eat some of the fluids that it secretes. They're kind of sweet. And they'll be around the brim of that trying to eat that fluid, and it'll actually slip down in there. And then when they try to crawl out, those hairs point straight down, so they actually can't get out once they fall in that trap. They'll try to crawl out of there and they can't. So it's really a cool carnivorous plant. You can see all the hairs on that one, right? See, it looks better without the light on it. You can see all those down-facing hairs. Another one right there, you can see all those. It just really traps the insects and they're not able to get out. So really, really cool carnivorous plant. Once you see an insect go down in there, you can actually just kind of watch it trying to get out, and it just keeps slipping back down in there. I've seen them get out before, but not usually. So this one's getting ready to go into dormancy here pretty soon, so it'll be going away for the winter. A lot of these will probably mostly die off. Nice thing about these ones is even though they die off, they kind of stay like this one here. They kind of stay that dark purple color for most of the winter, and then as they get really dead, they start to kind of fizzle out and dry up and kind of go like those ones there. But a really, really beautiful plant. I highly recommend getting a Sarracena purpurea no matter where you are. You just have to make sure that wherever you are, you can put these through a cold dormancy. You may have to do it in like a refrigerator or something, depending on your situation. But in most cases, places get cold enough to where you can put these through a cold dormancy. So thanks so much again for being here, guys. I really appreciate it. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video. Again, all that stuff is really helpful to me, and I really appreciate it. I hope you really like this plant, and I also really hope to catch you guys in my next video. Bye.